In South Africa, there are many inspirational men and women. And here on Movers and Shakers, you'll have the opportunity to get inside their heads. My name is Vusi Zion, and I'm on a quest to understand the path to success through the life stories of Mzansi's real visionaries.
I had a vision and a dream that one day I would have my own family.
You know, hard-nosed as she is, she's an nkululeko with a heart.
In South Africa, we grow up all the time being told that there are things we cannot do. I've always hated that.
She's very passionate. She's a visionary. She's focused. She's got strength and is ambitious.
Nonkululeko Gobodo is no stranger to success. She is, after all, South Africa's first qualified black female chartered accountant. Today, she's the chairman of the largest black-owned and managed accounting firm, the fifth largest accounting firm in South Africa.
It feels very good to be acknowledged and recognized after years of being disregarded. And when people now acknowledge that, in fact, we can entrust these things to you, yeah, it feels like the new South Africa. For the first time in my life, I feel like I'm in the new South Africa.
What was growing up like for you?
I learned very early in life to be sort of, to encourage myself and be self-motivated kind of person. But what was fortunate for me is that my father was in business, and at some point I worked in his panel beating shop. That's when I got exposed to accounting. That's when I learned about chartered accountants. I didn't even know there was such a thing. That's when I saw auditors for the first time.
She was expected to become a doctor. People thought she was crazy, but Nonkululeko threw herself into qualifying as a chartered accountant. She had no idea that if she did, she would be the first black woman to do so.
So I was studying for this exam, giving up everything to make sure that I attain it. It was so important for me to attain it, sacrificing anything, everything that I needed to sacrifice. So just passing was enough for me. So when I got the news that I had passed, it was like I was over the moon, you know, so excited. And then after that, then the whole drama happened. You were actually the first, and then it was magazines, TV news, and all of that. And I was like, no, sorry, you know, I'm a shy girl from the Transkei. I don't need all this publicity.
The accolades of her getting all this stuff as the first black female CA, it's important. I mean, it's important to us. We're very proud of that. But to her, that's not a big deal.
It goes without question that having been the first African woman to become a chartered accountant in the country means that she's a pioneer. She's broken new ground. She's done things that are first, not just qualifying as a chartered accountant, but also going on to establish one of the first black-owned, especially woman-owned, accounting firms in the country. Mm-hmm. And she's done a number of other things, you know, playing an advocacy role, playing a role of, you know, just making sure that we were not the only chosen few, but that we're creating opportunities for other people.
This is about mentoring younger people who do not even think this is possible. And so the whole excitement evaporated. I realized that there was a bigger responsibility upon my shoulders, that I had to succeed not just for myself, I had to succeed for those who were looking up to me. And it has always been the story of my life. I'm always get amazed when I meet even younger people today, maybe young professionals and all of that, who said, I'm a chartered accountant today because I saw a TV article about you and I said, I want to be like this lady. Or I meet chartered accountants today who said, you came to my school to speak. I can't tell you how rewarding that is. That your life had a bigger purpose than just your selfish needs.
Nonkululeko established her accounting firm in 1994, but this was not enough for her. She had a dream to build a big firm that would contribute to economic transformation. She went a long way towards accomplishing this dream when she was instrumental in the merger that formed Sizwe Ntsaluba Gobodo. You have a passion to set an example for effective economic transformation. Tell me about that passion.
Yes, you know, in South Africa, we grow up all the time being told that there are things we cannot do. You can't be this, you can't go into big business, you know, as a black person, you can, you know, we can assist you to develop a small business, even medium size, but big, please. I mean, come on. So I've always hated that because I grew up with a mother who always told me that there was nothing I couldn't do. So for me, I needed to see this thing happen for myself, that as a black person, I can start a big business in this economy. For me, economic transformation is about indigenous firms moving from small to medium size to large, because our economy should provide that kind of growth for us.
She's a visionary. The vision was that we want to have a big firm, massive firm, that is going to deliver to the communities, it's going to deliver to the country, and as a result of that delivery, the country would be proud of the firm. That has been her vision all along since we started. So she's passionate not only about the success of the firm, she's passionate about the success of the country. I mean, that could seem to be too far-fetched, but it's important because she's saying, well, if we fail as a firm, everybody's looking at us, and if we fail, we would have failed not only the firm, but the country as a whole.
Nonkululeko is building a lasting legacy. Part of that legacy lies in what we can learn from her about being a leader, being successful, and the vision she holds.
A determination that says to yourself and to the rest of the world that you have to take responsibility for yourself. That says you have to be determined to work hard. You have to be a person that is driven, that has ambition. And she certainly exhibits a lot of those characteristics. But at the same time, once you have succeeded, it's absolutely important to take other people along.
For me, having come to this place is incredible. I mean, it's like a dream come true. But of course, this is the beginning. This is really just only the beginning, because there's still so much more that we have to achieve. Also, we have to sustain what we've started. You know, it's pointless to start a big black business that is not sustainable. So everything that we do at Sesonsaloba Koboto now is to make sure that we sustain what we've started. And for me, if I could see Sesonsaloba being a true global firm, I would feel that my job is done. They can let me retire.
Nonkululeko Gobodo encapsulates what it means to be a mover and shaker in South Africa. She's a pioneer with a dream to achieve something bigger than personal reward. We will all benefit from her passion for sustainable and effective economic transformation.